My pipe cleaners in half, I do cut them. Four. That's only four, so four more to go. It does make it easier when you're doing a bubble wreath if you already have your twist ties or your pipe cleaners already on your wreath wire. That really doesn't happen for me because I never know which method I'm gonna use. For me, this is the quickest and the easiest because you don't have to do all that cutting and scrunching or rolling. She's a little busy. She doesn't get a lot of flowers. She doesn't get flowers at all. She doesn't get flowers at all on this one. If you want to add flowers, you can. But she won't be getting flowers. Have you guys hit that like and subscribe? Please do so I can bring you more videos. I said the next one that we're going to do, we're going to apply her to a wreath for the door. I actually did one of those today. And I will show you in the preview what she turned out to be, because that's going to be the next one that we make. That was my mistake for cutting that gold because I had a feeling I was gonna need it. I still have some from, I didn't cut it all up. Oh my. End of that roll. You can tuck this in, but I'm not because we're getting ready to, just gonna tuck it a little to, so it won't fray as much. And when you wrap your last piece, wrap it on just one bar. Don't put it through the two because unless you're using a cable tie. But this last one and the beginning one, I usually wrap on one piece of the wire on the wreath. Make sure it doesn't come unravel. Yeah, I don't want anything coming apart on me. Look at you. Glad we had this one left. So I was getting happy cutting my pieces, 10-inch pieces. 12-inch pieces. Also, guys, if you can leave in the comments, I'm running out of color coordinations. I really am. I did ask that question in the Facebook group. They gave me some nice color combos. I'm a monochromatic person, so I can make the solid color all day long. I really could, and be satisfied. You can get away with using one row of this 10-inch mesh if you use a smaller wreath frame. This one is 14 inches, so if you have 8 or 10, you would have more than enough. And then you wouldn't have to put 8 in the space either. to the wire, getting down to the wire. End of the road, end of the road, end of the road, end of the roll. Y'all think this overkill? I'd like to give people their money's worth. You're gonna die. My son's just cutting the grass today, and every time they come in, the fly flew in. That about he flew back in. Maybe not the same one. Okay, let's fluff and fluff. Y'all know what I'm gonna do when I finish this video with that mesh that I cut up. I'm gonna add her to something else. I'm happy with the way this bubble turned out. And hope to be happier when we apply her to this canvas. So that's what we get ready to do next. We get ready to apply her to the canvas. There she is, bubble wreath. So for my, if you're new to this channel, what I do is I use this Dollar Tree tool that can poke pin-sized holes into the canvas, and I use the pipe cleaner to attach it to the canvas. Take a look at her and see where you want to place. place the wreath. Sorry to have the back towards you guys, but I need her short hair to be in the front. There. So now I can show you. And I didn't wrap the pipe cleaner so tight that I can move a lot of this out of her face, but I want to cover her turban. So that's why I bought the wreath wire. If you can see, right below the turban. And that'll cover that space. So what you do is, you're gonna poke two holes. Two pinholes. And you're gonna put your pipe cleaner through and tighten it up from the back. The reason you put it between the bars is so that it won't tear your canvas. Don't want to tear your canvas. Sometimes it's not the little pinhole thingy, y'all. It's the pipe cleaner. Some of them are real stiff and some of them wires real flimsy. So because I know this is not going to move, I poked a larger hole. And I'm basically, because I don't want her to move from where I situated her, the wreath, I'm gonna twist it from just feeling it behind. And if you need to see, say I put it between those two bars. And you do that around the canvas to secure it, because your customer or yourself, whoever this is for, you won't need a hook on it because she's on a wreath wire already. She's on the frame. She's on the wire. What am I doing? I am hooking her close to the border of the frame. One more and then she's done. You can do one of these, and if you have everything prepped, you can put it together in less than an hour. And this would have been less than an hour if I wouldn't have took those few minutes cutting up those couple pieces of mesh. A little tedious too, but she's tight on that side. Okay. If you can't see what I'm doing, guys, I'm just reinforcing the frame to the canvas, and I showed you, you poke two holes and you put the twist tie through the pipe cleaner, twist tie. Put through, and then you twist it in from behind. One more, and we're done. Goldie. She looked like somebody I know. Look, y'all, she's finished. And when you get done, you just play around with her hair until it's shaped. The bubble is shaped the way you want it to be around her face. I have to move some out of her eye.